Asian Xerxes. Xerxes is what? He was some character from 300. And by character from 300, I mean someone from mythology and or history. But 300 came to mind because that's the kind of schooling I have, is the media, right? Okay, so we have to take 2 damage, which is really not what I want to do, but that's fine. We're going to get Godless Shrine so we can duress him, and so that we can have... Well, I guess we could have got Blood Crypt. No, we're not playing any red cards other than Manual Door this game, so it's probably fine. I want to peek at his hand so that we can be sure we can sneak all our stuff through. Dispel is the one we want. Simic Charm is probably fine, but Dispel could cause us problems. We've got green. We could use another green. We've got black. We don't need another black. Just grab a Breeding Pool and play our land for the turn. So if he draws a land and plays Silverblade Paladin, it's going to put us in a spot where we're going to take a ton of damage, but he didn't draw that. Things are looking good. He drew a Fencing Ace, so he's a little stuck on mana over there. I think that Urban Evolution is going to be the way to go this turn. He could do 8, 9, he could do 11 damage from what he has in hand. But 11 damage is not 12 life. I am not going to hold up Negate, which is probably a mistake, but I don't want to just fart away 2 extra life. 3, and we're actually going to be dead next turn if he... Okay, well, we're not yet. So we have Negate up. 6, 7, 8. So we should be fine because we can live through a lot of things. We took his Dispel, which is good. 3, 4, 5. So he'll probably Simic Charm this. It doesn't. Awesome. I feel as though we should have, because that would force us to do something. We don't even have a Fog. This guy is playing not nearly aggressively enough, in my humble opinion. So, we're kind of in the same spot we were last turn, where we're dead to certain things. Okay, here's what I'm thinking. I'm thinking Snapcaster Duress. And we can Revelation for 2 as well. The reason that I'm doing this is because I want to get that Simic Charm from his hand. And this way we survive even if he draws a white land. I think he's playing not nearly as aggressively as he probably should, because if he had just used his mana last turn, we'd be in a much worse spot. Say he had Simic Charmed his dude, or he had dropped a Stranglerroot Geist. I know the assumption is, oh, they play Fog, they always have Fog. Well, you need to force them to use the Fog, and sometimes they just don't have it. We don't have Fog here. So he's thinking about using Simic Charm. Oh, actually, if he bounces our Snapcaster Mage, then we would be in a tough spot, but he didn't. So we can beat any of these, even if he draws white mana for that, we're in okay shape. Because we can block here and gain 2 life and not die. And then we would need to draw something, but we've got 3 draws plus this, 2 for this, and 1 more. So gaining a single life point seems worth it. 2 life points, rather. He's just not playing anything. That's a huge mistake because we don't have a Fog, we don't have a sweep, and we're just hanging on for dear life. If he had really added anything to the board, this game would have been very hard. And now when we play the Supreme, he's going to feel like he did something right, because he's going to be like, okay, he had the Supreme Verdict, but we didn't have the Supreme Verdict. We just drew it right now. Just in time, thank goodness. Otherwise, we're potentially dead on this very turn because we didn't have anything other than the Sphinx's Revelation. But But as is, his cautious play, passive play rather, has put us in a great position to win this game. So you bounce hexproof players out there, this is an opportunity to see how the match plays from my point of view and to adjust your play if you really want. I don't really want to help the enemy, but might as well. I guess you guys aren't really the enemy, we're all on the same team, but... Oh. No. Okay, I almost screwed it up and we died. Almost. Okay, so we still don't have a fog. We can gain 9 life, so we can get through even a Silver Blade Paladin. And it'd be bound to yield a fog if we really need a fog. Yeah, he needs to play more aggressive. He's really got to play more aggressive. So we could leave up negate mana, which seems worth it because he plays Dispel and 7 is a lot. Okay, we're going to take it. Man, I really hate his play. Like, we're on the end of it where it's very good for us, but it's still kind of frustrating because I want to help this guy. And the way he's playing just made it very easy. What should have been a very hard game, very easy to win. Figures that it's just going to run us out of Wraths, I think is his hope. I wouldn't call it a plan, I would call it a hope. Okay, well, we've got a Fog and a Negate in case he goes Strangle Root, Silver Blade Paladin. At this point, the game's pretty much locked up. Which he does have, actually. Or Rancor, or whatever. I guess I should have negated that, because now we need to play a Fog. Which we otherwise would not have to play. Okay, so how much mana do we have? Snap, Fog, Negate, Flash, and Door. Bang, bang, got him. Let's do it. Although, we could snap Terminus. 1, 2, 4, 5, 6. And Door, but we wouldn't have Negate mana up at that point. Having Negate mana is very important. I guess we could have just Doored during our turn. But what if he randomly has Acidic Slime, like one in his board for some corner case sideboarding situation that I don't comprehend? That'd be a problem. Problem that I don't want anything to do with. So he could have all the Purify the Graves. Actually, no. Purify the Grave. Yeah, we can deal with Purify the Grave. Got the Negate, bro. Silverblade Paladin. This is me saying... Foggy very much. Wait, why is he fogging? Why is he not playing Terminus? Shouldn't he be playing Terminus? Oh no, what is about to happen to me? Is it Door to Nothingness? Is that what's about to happen? He finally decided to commit to the board, but far too late. Sometimes people... Okay, we won. Sweet.